Okay, so this is what our random tester is going to look like. And now let's look at the implementation in Python. And what we're going to see is that since all I have is the reference implementation, I'm not actually going to be testing two implementations against each other. Rather, all I'm going to be doing is making up two random 64-bit integers and just running the high common bits and low common bits functions on them. So what we're going to do is we're going to be able to see code coverage, but I'm not actually checking the output for correctness. And I'm running 100,000 test cases. So let's run this under the coverage harness. And so you can see I'm asking here for branch coverage. So we've got lots of output, and the coverage should have been computed. And we see here is that out of 25 statements, we ran 23 of them, a couple of statements were missing, and we had a couple of partial branch coverage results. What you can see here is that we've executed the body of the loops, and we've returned out of this path, but we failed to take the exit branch from the loop, and we failed to execute the return statement. And the same thing has happened over here. So let's ask ourselves why completely random testing with valid inputs 100,000 times didn't manage to cover this. Well, of course, this is pretty easy to see. So we're generating two totally independent random 64-bit numbers, and the only way we can reach this case is if they're the same. So what are the odds of two randomly generating 64-bit integers being the same? They're extremely low compared to the number of test cases we're running. We're never going to test this case. If we're testing optimized implementations of these functions, this actually matters quite a bit more. When we do optimized implementations of these functions, we're going to use specialized instructions that modern architectures support for providing bit counts. And this is going to boil down to, at least if we're using GCC as a compiler, functions like this built-in CLZ and built-in CTZ, which, as you can see, CLZ returns the number of leading 0 bits in X starting at the most significant bit position. And we can use this to implement one of our bit functions by XORing together the two operands to get to turn common bits into leading 0 bits. And so what we can do is use an XOR operation to turn high-order common bits in our arguments into leading 0 bits, and then we can use this built-in CLZ to implement an extremely fast version of the high common bits function. And similarly, this built-in CTZ can be used to build an extremely fast low common bits. And so, but if you see here, if x is 0, that is to say, if the two inputs are equal, the result is undefined. So the implementation here is allowed to do something really weird in the case where we pass in two operands that are the same. But as we saw, our little random testing here has only a negligible chance of actually generating two arguments that are actually the same. So it's really a bad random tester for this case. So let's go back and try to do better.